Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. This video will be about implicit intents. So for now, we only dealt with explicit intents when we started a new activity with them. An explicit intent specifies which application will satisfy the intent by providing a specific class name. So in the previous videos where we just started the activity, only our own application satisfied our intents. So we explicitly specified the class name of the activity we want to start. But there is actually another type of intents, which is implicit. And implicit intents don't specify a specific app that will satisfy the intent. Instead, we rather declare a general action to perform. For example, if we want to provide a function in our app to take a photo, then we probably don't care which photo app the user uses. So we can just specify the general action, which is taking a photo, and let the user choose which photo app should do the photo. Or for example, if we want to view a PDF file that the user chose in our app, then we can specify the action that the user can choose which PDF reader app he wants to use for that. And in this example here, I want to show you how we can open a gallery app to choose an image and display it in an image view in our app afterwards. And this is actually much simpler than you may think. So let's start to go into your activity main.xml file. And here we want to create that image view where we want to display that image afterwards. I will set the width to 270 dp and the height to 480 dp. Then I will set the scale type to center crop, and I will set the ID of that image view to IV photo. And then we can close that tag off. And I want to add a button here. So whenever we click on that button, we want to open a gallery app that is installed on the device to choose an image from your gallery and display that image afterwards in this image view above here. So let's set the width to wrap content and the height to. And the text is choose photo. And I'll set the ID to button take photo. Then we can go into that design tab and set the constraints. I will take the image view and constrain it horizontally in parent and the top to the parent top. Then I will take the button and constrain the top to the image view bottom and also horizontally in parent. And that's everything for our activity layout. Let's jump into our mainactivity.kt file. And here we can now add an onClickListener to our button take photo. Button take photo dot set onClickListener. So now we want to specify that intent with the general action to choose a photo. So the Android system will provide all the available apps which are able to view photos from the device and show them to us so we can choose between them. So if you've watched the previous videos about intents, then we only used explicit intents. So we wrote something like intent. We need to import that. And in the constructor of that intent class, we provided the context. And here we provided a specific class that satisfies our intent. But in this case, we want to use this version of that intent constructor, which takes an action, which is a string, and we can provide an action for an intent if we write intent dot. And here we can see all the available actions that we can choose for our intent that are a lot. And what I will choose here is intent dot action get content. So that is used to actually get some kind of content from our device. Let's write dot also after that. And because action get content is actually very general, because content could be everything, not only images, we need to specify a specific type for that intent. And we do it by writing it.type is equal to, and here we can now specify which kind of content we are looking for. In our case, that is image slash and then that asterisk symbol. So that is actually considered a MIME type that will look for all images. And after the slash, we could provide different file endings such as JPEG or PNG This would only look for PNG files. This would only look for JPEG files. But if we use that asterisk symbol, then it will just look for every kind of image. And after that, we normally used that start activity function, which will start an activity. But this time we want to use start activity for result because we expect a result for that activity that we want to start. In this case, the activity that we want to start is the gallery app. So it's not an activity from our app. Instead, it's an external activity. And we expect to get a result from that activity, which is the chosen image. And this is why we need to use the start activity for result function here. Then we need to provide an intent. So this is just it. And after that, we need to provide a request code. I will set that to 0. And that request code means that we have a way to differentiate between several activities that were started for result. So imagine we would also start an activity for result for taking an image. So with a photo application, then the request code would be something else. So Android Studio can differentiate between those two datas. So it knows that this one image comes from the photo app and the other image comes from the gallery app. And to actually get the data of that gallery app, so the data of the activity we started here, we need to override onActivityResult. So press enter. Ignore that super implementation here. And here we first need to check if that result code here is equal to result okay. So if everything went well. So if result code is equal to result okay. Press enter here and it will insert activity.result okay. And we also want to check if our request code here is equal to the request code that we provided here. So equal to 0. So and request code is equal to 0. And as you can see, in the parameter list of that function, we can get the data in form of an intent. So we can get the actual path to that image that we just chose from that data intent here. And the path to an image in Android or to actually any kind of content is considered an URI. So let's write val URI is equal to data, which is our intent. And because that is nullable, you can see that at that question mark here, we need to also make a question mark here and write dot data. So that is actually maybe a little bit confusing. We could also rename this to something else. That data just refers to our intent, and that data refers to the data of our intent. So in this case, if you click Control and Q here on that data, then you can see that just returns a URI here. And that is just the address of our chosen image. And because we know that address, we can simply write IVPhoto, which is our image view, dot set image URI, and then set it to our URI. And yeah, that's it. We can run our app now. And if we now click on choose photo, then our standard gallery app will open, but we also have the possibility to choose between different gallery apps. So I just installed some random gallery apps here from Google Play to show you that this also works with other apps. So I took a photo here with that emulator. If I click on this, then it will just show up in our image view. But when I rerun that app so that the image view is empty again and click on choose photo again, then let's choose a different app here, for example, this one. Then you can see I can choose the same photo from that gallery app. And if I click on it, then it will work fine. So now we are able to choose any photo from any gallery app and display it in our own application. I hope this was helpful for you. If so, please leave a like and comment below. Also, if you have any questions, then don't mind asking them in the comments. And if you have some feedback for me, that would be really helpful. If there's anything I can improve on, then don't mind writing that in the comments too. And yeah, see you in the next video. Have a good day.